Hello, I'm Katie and welcome back to my channel. Today I am painting a piece that I'm doing for Gouachevember. Gouachevember is a challenge on Instagram and to paint a gouache painting every day for a month. This one's still a little wet, I just finished it. But so these are what I've done. I'll flip through more at the end when this is dry. But it was... The prompt for day 7 is vote, and I am in Georgia, so I figured I would do a Georgia voter. Right now, I'm trying to find my little eraser, because I like using my little Tombow eraser to clean up my sketch before I start painting. I prefer to sketch before I paint, just so that I know I'm gonna get what I want on there, and then I can just work in layers and use the full potential of gouache by working in layers. So this is just a rough little sketch that I created for vote, and I'm gonna use a kneaded eraser to sort of lighten it up. I wanted you to see, hopefully you can see on camera what I have drawn. It just says I'm a Georgia voter. Basically, I'm just redoing the, like, making my version of the Georgia vote sticker, which there is nothing for me to vote for this year. So even though November 7th is, you know, there's some things in our area, but it's just not for my exact district. So yep, so I'm just redoing my, what I would say is the Georgia voter sticker. But yeah, so I'm just trying to lighten it up and just trying to take away some of that graphite from my pencil. Yeah, I've been sketching a few different ones. Like, well, I've sketched that one. It's gonna be a collection, but yeah, just to get some ideas. So yeah, this one is number 7, vote, and I'm actually gonna erase that off. I'll erase it right before I publish it anyway, but yeah. So I'm using Holbein acrylic gouache for my paintings, and the Georgia voter sticker is, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's a peach, so it's not like, you know, something big that I'm drawing. I'm going to Georgia voter sticker. I'm going to look it up on my phone right quick and see, well, Georgia voter sticker, and let's see if I can get it. There we go. That is what the Georgia voter sticker looks like. I'm a Georgia voter, which cracks me up that they are selling the vote stickers on Redbubble. But yeah, that's the Georgia voter sticker, and I'm just doing my own version of it because I wanted to play around with this one. So what I'm using is, I'm going to be using Juan Brilliant, coral red, orange yellow. I have wine. I'm definitely going to be needing white. And then for my greens, I'm just going to mix a green using primary yellow and Prussian blue, just because I like the way those greens, the green I get from that works. So my palette is just a little plate, which I, because I still have some of the blue on there, that's the reason I'm using the Prussian blue. But yeah, so that's what I'm using. Those are my colors. I'll put them in the description box below. The one brilliant works great for peach. It does, it's already sort of peachy, and I'm just going to do a very light wash of it right now. I really need to get some fresh water. My water is a little nasty, but it's all right. So I'm just going to do just a light wash over the whole peach. With the one brilliant, and I am using a Royal Talons Art Creations sketchbook for this. This is my go-to sketchbook now. I saw Katie Moody use it. April from Monkey Mantaka uses it and uses them, and I really had a hard time finding them for a while, and then my local Michaels brought them in as a seasonal product back during the summer. And so when they do a seasonal product, they normally will, once that seasonal product end cap is ready to be taken down, they'll start clearancing them. So I bought a whole bunch of them at like 70% off. So I have a really good stash of them now. But then I did find out one of the art stores that I visit in Atlanta, which is still about still over an hour away from my house to get to a good art supply store, they carry the Royal Talons sketchbooks. So that is gonna be great. So I just did it with a dark undertone right now, just for the sake of trying to get some color on there. That Juan Brilliant, I'm going to end up lightening it up with white and things like that. And now I'm gonna do, I don't need such a light wash for my leaves. I'm just gonna mix a little bit of this Prussian blue, just a tiny, tiny bit of Prussian blue with primary yellow. And I really like that green. That green to me is one of my favorites, especially for painting leaves. So I'm gonna come in. I don't like it for a lot of background, but as my base for these leaves, I am going to use it. I have a bunch of other videos that I have filmed the content for. I just have not edited them yet. And so this one is going to go up probably unedited. I'm probably just going to keep it like this. I'm not going to do a lot of editing for it, just because it is a process video and I'm just showing how I paint with gouache and playing around in my sketchbook. You know, I mean, doing this challenge was really just was to give me something to do to get my mind off of my work, because work's been busy, and so this is just my relaxation. And so that is the reason I've been sharing it, but you know, not really filming it, because this was just a way for me to practice working with gouache, because I haven't really worked with it for a while, and I feel like I'm really, really, really out of it. And now I'm just mixing a little bit more, a different shade, but adding a little, you know, just to add some depth to these leaves. Can add just a little more yellow to get a lighter green, a little more blue to get a darker green. But this works really good with the Juan Brilliant Peach, because it is very, you know, it's a complementary color. So there we go, there's my leaves. I know probably you can see it a little bit better on camera than I can, because right now I've got a little bit of glare where I'm painting. I'm gonna blend that out just a tad. There we go. Now I'm gonna take some white and a smaller brush. These are brushes I got off of Amazon. They're just they're for miniature painting. They're Nick Pro Set, and I really like them. They're all round. There are some very small ones in here. I do have a good, you know, I have the collection of them. And I like them when I'm painting like this, because I can get the detail that I want. But I'm gonna add a little bit of white in with this Juan Brilliant to pop some little highlights up here on this peach. Yeah, this is just a fun process for me. You can also add just a little bit of yellow if you didn't want a white highlight, you could add yellow and make a yellow, more natural highlight here with this one brilliant. I think I made it a little too yellow, so let's just I'm not painting a realistic peach here, I'm just painting a sticker. But yeah, it's just my interpretation of this sticker. And now I'm just adding a little more straight of the Wand Brilliant. One of the things that, since I've been using gouache, is that I have to remember is that it dries darker than what it looks like. At least these paints do. They seem to dry a little bit darker than, you know, what you see when it's wet. So if you want it lighter, you need to go ahead and lighten it up a lot more. And now I'm going to grab just a tiny bit. I may not even use all these yellow, these colors that I showed at the beginning. And I'm just going to get just a tiny little bit of this wine red and water it down considerably and bring it. Because remember, it's easier to darken up a color than it is to lighten it up. So I'm just going to add a little bit of that wine red to give me this outline down here, but I need it to not be that red. So we're going to add a little more Wand Brilliant to that and blend it in. But you know, peaches really do have lots of different shades of reddish peach, cream, you know, this color, apricot, however, you know, whatever color this you call it, it does have a lot of the different colors in it. And if my outline is not exactly like I like right here, it's going to be fine because I'm going to paint white after everything dries and paint white to make this a sticker. To actually make it the vote sticker. But yeah, there we go. And for the Georgia voter wording, I'm going to let this, it looks like it's good. I am going to mix some of the Prussian blue with the wine red, and a little bit of this yellow. I don't like using black, not straight black, so I'm using the Prussian blue, the wine red, and some of the primary yellow to create my own black. And the reason I do this is just because, I don't know, I like it better. I really don't know how to explain it. I just like it better. And it does, you know, it gives a different tone. It just looks better to me. Now I'm going to have to turn this because I'm going to be painting these letters. But, so yeah. And I don't know what it is about the letter I. It is the hardest letter to make for me to write. It's been that way all my life. I have no clue why. The letter I just don't like it. I'm trying to make these a little bit curvy. Alright, sorry about that interruption. So, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to make it a little bit curvy because the original one had more of a script. But I'm adding my own little flair to it, to the lettering here. And you know, painting lettering, go slow. Change your direction of your brush. Don't try to make the whole letter in one stroke because it will not work. So, you know, that E just took me 3 strokes, but that's fine. And this O may take me 3 strokes. There we go. Yeah, it's fun. Doing these letters like this, just, it's a relaxing process to me, painting these letters. But I prefer to do it from a sketch. And that way, I don't think you can see my pencil line underneath on camera. but I can see my pencil line. Also, try to keep your brush strokes. Don't go up. If you go up, you'll lose some control and it won't be smooth. So, always try to go down. At least that's how I work. I just don't like going up with, I don't like an upstroke. I don't feel like I have the same control over my brush when it's an upstroke. Just the little hook is what I, you know, it's fine, but I just don't like going on an upstroke. And I'm going to use the same color to paint the stem, and I'm going to turn my page around. This is how I work for everything. Whenever I'm painting anything, I always like turning it around because that way I'm pulling the brush toward myself instead of pushing it away. So I'm going to paint my stem. Yep, I like to pull it toward me. And the same, I'm gonna take this color that I've got right here, and I'm gonna take a little bit of the green and add more green to it to add the veins to the leaf. So, oh, sorry, I was out of the picture, but there, it's just a little, I've added green to this same mix that I just mixed. And this will let me make my veins on my leaves that the color looks right. It actually, you know, it doesn't, it's not too stark. I was watching something, I don't even remember where I was watching it, but it's about color mixing with the mother color, I think is what they call it. It's so that when you're mixing your colors, all of your colors will go together because they have this mother color in it. And so now I'm going to add a little bit more yellow to that mix that I was doing for the veins, and just a little bit of a shadow here underneath that leaf. Just a little bit, just something to add, just, I don't know, just add a pop. It makes sense to me. And then the same with the underneath the leaf on the peach. I'm going to take just a tiny bit of that wine red and a lot of the Wine Brilliant and some water. And make myself a shadow color. You can also use a little bit of that stem color in there as well to make a good shadow color, because we have a shadow underneath our leaves here. There we go. A little bit of shadow underneath our leaf. And right there. Now I'm just going to take my wet brush and blend that a little bit out so it's not so stark. Same over here. Just blend it out. And there we have it. And now what I'll have to do is let this dry, and I'll come back in and paint the actual sticker part white. So I'm gonna pause a second. It won't be much for you, and it'll only be a second for you, and then I will dry this and come back. All right, all my edges are dry that I can paint around, that I need to paint around. So I am going to use a little wider flat brush. When I'm painting my sketchbook, I use really small brushes. It's just, to me, it's all about control because I am very tight. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this white, and I'm going to find a place I can mix some water in with it. And like I said, I need clean water. I'm really bad about changing my water out. But I'm just going to thin this down to about the consistency of heavy cream. I think that's how I would consider that, just cream. And then, like I said, I'm going to turn my page, turn it a few times. But I'm going to paint the actual sticker. I just thought this one was more fun to film than any of the others I've done. And I had time to film this one instead of just painting. I had time to get all my setup out and everything. So I'm just going to go around and paint the sticker. Yeah, I'm not the type who can just paint in one direction, with it sitting in front of me. So I do turn my page, turn my paper, whatever I'm painting. If I'm painting a canvas, I don't really use an easel a lot because I like to be able to just flip it. And I like painting flat. Just works better for, my dexterity, pretty much. I can just paint it. And I'm not really looking to have a pure white here. Or to be, fully white. I think you can tell it's painted. And when it dries, you definitely will be able to tell that I've painted it white. And the ink one is definitely drying, and I was really going for trying to be more vintage, but I think I'm going to clean up the outline of that label after I finish filming this. After I finish painting this one, I may go back over there and finish it. So, yeah. Check it out on Instagram. My Instagram is Katie Cannon Designs, and I'll post the finished spread there. I've been posting these every other day. Like, I'm not posting, well, I am posting them pretty much every day. It's just I'm a day behind because I like to have a spread to post. So, I have been waiting until I have both pages of my sketchbook finished before I share them. I've been sharing them on my stories, just not, I've been sharing them daily. It's just, I wait until I have a 2-day spread finished before I share it on my actual feed. All right, I'm about to switch to a smaller brush as soon as I get this outline here done. One reason, like I said, I am pretty tight when it comes to painting because I draw mostly. And so I look at painting as drawing with my brush. And so it's just ends up how it is that I'm tight. I try to loosen up, but it's not my style. My style is, it's being a little more tight and clean. And that's the reason the blue bottle, the ink bottle, is bothering me, is because it's not tight and clean. Alright. And now the little sticker is done. I may need to come back and paint over a couple of things, like maybe this This part of the leaf needs a little bit more. And now I've overworked it. Well, we'll see. Let's see. That's why, you know, when I'm working with acrylic wash, I work with it in thin layers and build it up so that I can see something underneath it. Like this right here. Clean that up. And there we go. It is finished. I hope you've enjoyed this, my little chatty paint with me. And I hope to do more of these soon. I may film some more of these gouache vimber as paint with me. I would love to know if you are participating in any daily challenge. And if you like this video, hit that subscribe button and leave me a comment and let me know what your favorite art supply is and what you like to paint or draw. I'd love to hear from you. See you soon.